Module 2, Section 8.4, Applications of Right Triangles. Before we get started looking at applications, I want to take a quick look at significant digits. Most values of trigonometric functions and virtually all measurements are approximations. Significant digits represent the accuracy of the measurements. So we have the following breakdown. Basically, an angle of measure to the nearest degree would have two significant digits. An angle of measure to the nearest 10 minutes would have three significant digits, and so on. So, for example, if we have 52 degrees 30 minutes, that would be to the nearest 10 minutes, and this has three significant digits. So let's do an example. We want to solve a right triangle, and in this first one, we have angle A is 31 degrees 40 minutes, and side A is 35.9 kilometers. So I'm going to label our triangle here, and our side opposite angle A would be side A. So the remaining sides, we know that angle C is 90 degrees in our right triangle here. So we need to find angle B, we need to find side B, and we need to find side C. So first let's find angle B. We know that B and A are complementary, or they add up to 90 degrees. So angle B would be 90 degrees minus angle A, which is 31 degrees 40 minutes. So we end up with a value of angle B of 58 degrees and 20 minutes when we do our subtraction. Now let's find side B. We know that the tangent of the angle we just found, angle B, 58 degrees, 20 minutes, would be the opposite side, which is side B, over the adjacent side, which is side A, or 35.9. Now to solve for B, we're going to multiply both sides by 35.9. So we have that side B would be 35.9 times the tangent of 58 degrees 20 minutes. When we perform this multiplication, we get a value of side B of approximately 58.2 kilometers. And the last side we need to find is side C. You could use the Pythagorean theorem, but I'm going to go ahead and use our angle A, and we'll use side A. So we have the sine involving the opposite of the hypotenuse of 31 degrees 40 minutes, which would be A, or 35.9, over C. So in this case, we multiply both sides by C, and then we would end up with C times the sine, 31 degrees 40 minutes, equal to 35.9. And to solve for C, we would divide both sides by the sine of our angle. So we end up with a value for side C of 68.4 kilometers. Now let's solve another triangle, and this time, instead of being given an angle and a side, we're given two sides. So we have side C is 12. And side B is 6.9. So we need to find angle A, angle B, and we need to find side A. So let's find side A first, and we'll use the Pythagorean theorem, knowing that A squared plus B squared equals C squared, or that A squared would be C squared minus B squared. So then that gives us that A would be the square root of C squared minus B squared. So it's the square root of 12 squared minus 6.9 squared. So we get a value for A of approximately 9.8 feet. Now let's find our angle B. Since we were given the opposite and the hypotenuse, we'll use sine. So the sine of B would be side little b over the hypotenuse C, or 6.9 over 12. When we find this ratio, it equals out to be 0.575. So we have the sine of B is 0.575. To find B, we then use the inverse sine of our angle. And we'll get an approximate value using degrees of 35 degrees. Once we found B, A is relatively easy. Since they add up to be 90 degrees, side A will be 90 degrees minus side B, or 35 degrees. So we get a value for A of 55 degrees. Now let's find the measure of the angle formed by the line passing through the origin and the positive part of the x-axis on a calculator screen. We'll use the values displayed at the bottom. So we're going to use this triangle here. And so we end up with an angle, theta, here. The value here would be our y, which was 13.75, as we see at the bottom here. And here would be x, which is 5.5. And this is our right triangle. So we're trying to find the value of theta, and we know the opposite and the adjacent side. So we know that tangent involves those two sides. So the tangent of theta would be 13.75 over 5.5, or 2.5. So to find theta, we're going to take the tangent inverse of 2.5, and we want it to be in degrees, so make sure you're in degree mode when you do this, and you'll end up with a value approximately of 68 degrees for theta. Now, before we actually do some applications or word problems, we want to look at angles of depression or elevation. Basically, an angle of depression has its terminal side below the horizontal, and an angle of elevation has its terminal side above the horizontal. So let's solve an application problem. The steps, first, we want to draw a sketch and label it with the given information, then label the quantity to be found with a variable. Step 2, we'll use our sketch to write an equation relating the given quantities to the variable. And step 3, we want to solve the equation and check that the answer makes sense. A 13.5 meter fire truck ladder is leaning against a wall. Find the distance D the ladder goes up the wall, above the top of the fire truck, if the ladder makes an angle of 43 degrees 50 minutes with the horizontal. So we have the following picture, and notice our angle is labeled, the ladder is labeled, and our side D, the distance that it goes up the wall, is labeled as well. So we have our angle, the side opposite, and the hypotenuse, which involves sine. So the sine of 43 degrees 50 minutes would be our opposite side, which is D, over our hypotenuse, which is 13.5. So now we need to solve for D. We'll multiply both sides by 13.5. So we see that D is 13.5 times the sine of 43 degrees 50 minutes. Let's actually perform this calculation on the calculator. So we want to make sure we're in degree mode. And we have 13.5 times the sine of 43 degrees, 50 minutes. So we get a value of D of 9.3496. So D is approximately 9.35 meters. Let's look at one more example. Suppose that the angle of elevation of the sun is 23.4 degrees. We want to find the length of the shadow cast by a woman who is 5.75 feet tall. We have the following picture. Here's our angle of elevation above the horizontal, 23.4 degrees. Here's our woman, and our height is labeled as 5.75. What we want to find is the length of our shadow, so we'll call that x. Notice that we have our angle, the side opposite, and the side adjacent, so we're dealing with tangent. The tangent of 23.4 degrees, then, would be the opposite side, 5.75, over the adjacent side, x. So we need to solve for x. First, we multiply by x. And then we divide both sides by the tangent of our angle. So we have that x is 5.75 divided by the tangent of our angle, or 13.2875. So the length of the shadow, x, is approximately 13.3 feet.